Hi, my name is Brian Norton with the InData Project at Easterseals Crossroads, and today we're going to be talking about an accessibility setting on iOS devices called Side Button. So let's go ahead and take a look. So today we're going to talk about a little known accessibility feature called Side Button. So here I am in my settings. I'm going to go down to Accessibility. I'm going to scroll down to Side Button. And for a lot of folks who maybe you're an older adult, clicking that side button fast enough sometimes can be really problematic. And when you use that side button, you can open up different apps, you can open up your wallet, you can open up, you know, the accessibility feature menu. And if you go under side button, you have some options to be able to either slow down that double click or have some variations so that if you do have difficulty quickly making those clicks on that button, you can slow that down so that it won't go ahead and just recognize it separately as clicks, but it'll actually combine the clicks that you use if you go slow. And so you have some different click speeds you can choose, and you just have to tap the one that you want. I'm going to go ahead and leave mine at default. The other thing that's here is you have a couple of options, and so what I use my side button for is I press and hold to bring up Siri all the time. I do have difficulty with taking pictures because I end up holding the other side of my phone, which is the volume up, and then the power button, which is the side button they're talking about right here, and that actually will snap a picture for you. But anyways, back to the point, when I press and hold, currently I bring up Siri, so that's typically checked. I can also choose voice, classical voice control, or I can also choose off. And so I've got some different settings where I can change how that and what that particular side button controls. And then if I'm using my Apple Wallet with a lot of things, if I want to make payments or confirm my payments using assistive touch or switch control, you have some enable confirms with either switch control or assistive touch at the bottom. And so if I want to, and I'm using, let's say I'm using switch control and I want to use my side button to confirm a payment, which is often the case when you purchase something, they're wanting you to double click on your power button. Well, now you can do that using switch control or assistive touch. And so a couple of different features underneath there, but important for some folks, specifically if you have difficulty making very quick clicks with that button, and then changing the way and the features that are operated using that side button as well. Well, that's your tech tip for today. I want to say thank you to the Indiana Telephone Relay Access Corporation for sponsoring our captions today. My name is Brian Norton with the InData Project at Easterseals Crossroads in Indiana.